in this series, we've been looking at how to manage our driftable fines. Obviously, we've had a look at nozzles. They really have a large impact on our production of driftable fines. But we can now fine tune this with their selection of adjuvants. We normally partner the adjuvant with the herbicide of choice, but we should start to consider the impact that will have on our driftable fine production. We've set up this rogator here for this demonstration today. We have a good 17k hour wind. We want to run some water through some AIXR nozzles, and then we'll run through some BS1000 activator and some Collide 700. And we should see some visual differences through that adjuvant selection. For our baseline, to start with in this example, we have water going through at 2.8 bars. Now we move on to BS1000 at 120 mils per 100 litres, and you can see distinctly the increased driftable fine produced. While BS1000 is a cost-effective adjuvant, you need to be mindful of the extra driftable fines it can produce. So we've cleaned out the tank, now we're moving into activator at 100 mils per 100 litres of water, and you'll see now we're back to a more drift neutral state. Anywhere a product recommends the use of a non-iodine wetter, activator can be used to replace BS1000. We've cleaned out the tank again and we're moving on to Collide 700. We're using this at 300 mils per 100 litres of water. When drift risk is increased, you should do everything you can to reduce your driftable fines produced. This demonstration shows us the impact adjuvants do have on production of driftable fines. As a spray industry, and in our applicators, it's our duty of care to ensure that we are minimising our drift downwind, and adjuvant selection can assist in that process.